Good morning, all of you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you all?
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you all? You all enjoyed your vacations?
Yes.
Diwali break. After Diwali break, we can see you with the new faces, new. Yes, with the fresh, energetic. Yes. So, are you all ready to learn the new things?
Yes.
As you all know that we have already covered and completed 10 chapters in our math textbooks. Right. We have learned 10 topics, right? So in that we have learned multiplication also in previous chapters. We have learned division also in previous chapter, but that was not completely. But these topics are coming in our last chapters also. And the last chapter, which was chapter number 10, was related with the patterns. Mohit, can you please sit straight and put it down? Yes. And children, I request everyone, please do not try this background image in the maths class. It's my request to everyone, please don't try this, change the layout background in your maths class especially. Otherwise, your mind will be diverted in that and you will not able to pay the full attention in your class. Okay? Yes. So, as you all know that we have done our last chapter, which was related with the patterns. Ayush, you want to say something? Your mic is not on.
No, ma'am. I was saying to just my grandmother.
Okay.
I wanted water.
Okay, no problem. So now we are going to start the chapter number 11, which is tables and shares. I will ask, please raise your hand and I will ask you, my first listen my question and then raise the hand and then I will ask. My question is, what are we going to learn in this chapter? Why the name of this chapter is tables and shares? And what are we going to learn in this chapter? I need the new hands also. These children are regularly giving me the answers like Dereth, Visha. They are active. What about the other children, please?
Ma'am, tables.
We are learning about the tables. Okay, what do you mean by the table? Table is the table in the kitchen and in the your dining room.
Max table.
Yes, and what do you mean by the word chairs?
Ma'am, may I see?
Ma'am, yes. May I see?
Yeah. Ma'am, in chairs, ma'am. If we have four chocolates.
Yes.
And I have three friends. Anvi,
wait a minute. Anvi, let's.
Ma'am, you have to share sharing.
So yes, I have four chocolates and I have to share the chocolates in me and my three friends. So how will I share? So that is means of share. So I will share one to each.
Means, can you please explain me, who will explain me in the easy words, what do you mean by the word, in one word? What do you mean by the word?
Ma'am, simple words.
Children, now we have raising hand option also. And when you raise your hand, I will able to see you also. So why you all speak together? Yes, Lamha. Can you please explain me in one word, what do you mean by the word share?
Division.
Ma'am, share divide. Is a very simple, I agree. We have to divide it in equal parts.
Yes.
Okay, yes, we have to divide. It is not necessary that we get the equal parts. We divide, yes, we sometimes when we divide, we get the fraction, we get the remainder also. Right?
Yes.
Yes or no? Yes. So, but the share means to divide. Tables and shares means in this chapter we are going to learn about the multiplication and the division. What are we going to learn in this chapter? All, please all repeat after me. All of you repeat the answer. Multiplication.
Multiplication and division.
Multiplication and division. Right? And for learning the multiplication, what is the very first thing we should know?
Tables.
Very good. So, in my next class, I want that everyone should learn tables from 2 to 15 and be ready. I can ask any time. Before we have done 2 to 10 or 2 to 12 something, now it is extended to 2 to 15. Everyone has to learn the tables from 2 to 15, right? Okay.
Ma'am.
Even after saying ma'am, why you stop? Say what you want to ask.
Ma'am, I know the table till 16.
Okay, very good. Ma'am, if you know the table, till 16, very good.
Table 0 to 19.
Okay.
Ma'am, I know till 20.
Very good, my dear children. Very good. Excellent.
Ma'am, I also know till 20.
Stop now. Stop your mute your mics. Okay. So now before starting the chapter, first we should know the multiplication properties, which we have already learned in our last previous chapters in grade 4. When we have started initially, when we have started our class, we have learned about the properties of multiplication. But again, we are revising the multiplication properties so that you will again recall it and able to do it easily. So I will show you one video on multiplication properties. You have to write these multiplication properties in your notebook along with the video. I will pause the video in between. You have to write that in your notebooks. Write today's date. Write chapter number 11. Write the topic multiplication properties. Be ready and then I will play the video. Write today's date in your notebook. Write chapter number 11, name of the chapter, tables and shares. Name of the chapter, tables and shares. And then you have to write the properties of multiplication. I will play the video, please. Catherine, ma'am, please note, are they all writing in their notebooks or not? It is compulsory for everyone has to write in their notebooks.
Ma'am, can you repeat one more time?
Before starting, when you start the chapter, what is compulsory to write in the chapter, Vivan? In the notebook? Name of the chapter, chapter number, date and the topic.
Okay. Ma'am, topic subtract multiplication.
Multiplication properties.
Okay.
Multiplication concept and properties is your today's topic. Are you all ready so that I can play this video? And you will be able to write it. Can I start?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay.
Concept and properties. Review. You have already learned the multiplication concept and properties in the earlier grades. Today, let us review both the concept and properties. Look at the board. We all know that multiplication is repeated addition. Now,
write this in your notebook. The concept of multiplication is a repeated addition. Please write this in your notebooks. Multiplication is repeated addition.
Ma'am,
video from starting.
Nothing is there from starting. This is the starting only.
Ma'am, we have to write example.
Yes, you have to write the example also. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 times if I write 3. 3 plus 3 plus 3, 8 times when I write, I will get 24. And same if I do 8 multiply by 3 equals to 24.
Ma'am, what is topic?
Topic is multiplication concept and multiplication properties. I will write the topic in the chat box. After my message, please, no one will message in the chat box. Multiplication concept and multiplication properties. This is the topic. After the topic, you have to write this first sharp concept, which is multiplication is repeated addition.
Now, let us recall the terms. Here, 3 is the first factor or the multiplicand.
Ma'am, what is the topic?
8 is the second.
It's already in the chat box.
Ma'am.
Who is this? Yes, Meghdad.
Meghdad. And we have to write this 3 8s are
in yes, first. Yes, you have to write with the example. Yes. This first factor and second factor.
And we have to write like two ones only.
Listen to me now, everyone. This is not compulsory to write the first factor and second factor, but this side is compulsory to write. 3 is the multiplicand. 8 is the multiplier.
Factor
and 24 is the product,
and 24 is the
right hand side is compulsory to write. Don't write the left side. Terms you,
ma'am. If we write
in the first example, we have to write 3 plus 3 plus.
Yes, I am explaining from the beginning that what is there showing on the screen, you have to write everything except terms in multiplication. Don't write this side, the first, second factor. You have to write the right hand side that 3 is the multiplicand, 8 is the multiplier, and 24 is the product.
Ma'am, I have written that first factor and second factor.
It's okay if you have written. Please write it fast. Multiplication is a repeated addition. Who will give me one example with the repeated addition? Raise your hand. Yes, please, I want the new hands in my list. Yes, Anni, please explain me. What do you understand? Give me one more example, Anni. Can we please start?
Ma'am,
can I give?
Yes.
Can we please start?
You can see the question again.
Yes, my question is, can you give explain this repeated addition of multiplication?
Yes. Ma'am,
with example, one example.
Yeah, example like if I use 4 two times, it will be 2 multiplied by 4 is equal to 8.
2 4 times or 4 2 times?
2 4 times.
Okay, 2 4 times. So how many times you will write when you are doing with the repeated addition? How many times you will write 2?
2 I will write 4 times.
How you will write?
मैम लाइक 2 + 2, 2 + 2 ऐसे लाइक
like this. Okay, so and if you want to show this in the multiplication form, how you will write?
Sorry,
if you want to show this repeated addition into the multiplication form, how you will write it?
I will write 4 × 2 is equal to
4 × 2 or 2 × 4?
2 × 4.
Okay, and what have you observed? The answer will be different or answer will be same?
It will be same.
What will be your answer when you add 4 × 2 or multiply it? What will be your answer?
8.
The answer will be same.
8.
When you do it with the repeated addition or when you do it with the multiplication, the answer will be same. Please write one example of multiplication in the chat box.
Ma'am, I have to ask you something. Can I ask?
Yes, I ask. Please ask.
Ma'am, we have to write this 3 + 3 + 3 + 3.
Yes, you have to write.
Renu,
yes, Parinika, please go. Yes, there.
Ma'am, I want to ask you that. This we are making the problem in like this 3 + 3 + 2 like that. You have to write in our notebook also.
Yes, you have to write it.
Our own also in the notebook you have to write.
Yes.
I am asking that. Look, I have made like 2 + 2 + 2. So it is 3. So 3, then 2 + 2 + 2. And
if you add 2 3 times, what will be your answer?
Then I did 3 × 2, then I got 6.
Excuse me.
My notebook.
Adhairya, your voice is not clear. I'm not able to hear you clearly. You please write whatever is required in the chat box.
Excuse me, ma'am. Ma'am, I can't find the multiplication sign, so I am putting a slash. Is it okay?
You have an X sign in your keyboard, right? Use the X sign for multiplication.
X sign. I don't have, but I have the normal X.
Normal X only. Use it as for multiplication sign. Okay. Yes, I can see the children are writing 10 + 10, and then let me read. Kahan has written 2 × 2 × 2, 6. Yes, 2 × 2. Then you have to write 2 × 8. Yes, 2 × 3. How many times you are writing 3? Yes. 4, you have written 5 times. So it's 20. Yes, Jishna. Very good. Prisha, yes. Lamha, please correct it.
Yes, sorry, ma'am. It happened.
Yes, Rudra. Mm-hmm. Good.
Ma'am, I have to ask you something. Can I ask?
Yes, I ask.
Ma'am, the second one.
Ma'am, see Maya also.
Yes, Lakshya.
Ma'am, multiply is the repeated addition, then next one. We have to write just right side or both?
Right side. Multiplicand, multiplier and the product.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. See, children, I will send this video in the classroom also. If you're able to finish it in the class, please finish it. Then I will play it again. And if you're not able to complete it in the given time, you complete it when I will send it in the classroom. Okay.
Clear?
Wait a minute, I will see. You have written in the chat box?
No, ma'am. My laptop, there is no plus sign. I want to ask that I have made the word problem as 2 + 2 + 2 + 2. Means 3 + 2 means 3 + 2 is equal to 6.
So 3 + 2 is equal to.
No, ma'am. Means 2, 2, 2, and +2. So 3.
Can you please, Dara? That's why I am telling you. Please write write in the chat box because you are not clearly audible to me.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, I will come back to you again. Let me play this now. Everyone has to complete their.
Now, let us review the multiplication properties.
There are four different properties of multiplication: cumulative property, multiplicative property of zero, multiplicative property of one, and associative property.
And we have to write this
one.
You write it one by one.
Commutative then we have property. To write it when two numbers are multiplied together, the product is the same, regardless of the order of the factors.
Ma'am.
For example,
then we have to write it in the notebook.
My dear children, from the beginning we are doing this properties, and I'm saying we are writing. So you have to write it, Dehandalal. First, we have learned the concept of multiplication, which is multiplication is a repeated addition. Now we are doing the multiplication property. The first property of multiplication is the commutative property of multiplication. Please try to understand it and I will explain you again. When two numbers are multiplied together, whether it is any two numbers you can take, and when you multiply it, and if you reverse it, when you change it, like 4 multiplied by 3 is 12 and 3 multiplied by 4 is also 12. So when you change the digits, the position of the digits, then also you will get the same answer. So this commutative property says that when two numbers are multiplied together, the product is the same regardless of the order of the factors. If you change the order also, you will get the same answer. Please write this in your notebooks. Wait a minute. Yes.
Ma'am, you can send in classroom.
I will send it, but please try to complete it in the class also.
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am, I have left the meeting of the connectivity issue. So we have to write that this.
Ayanch, from the beginning we are writing, no?
Yes.
So you have to write this, yes.
Okay, ma'am.
So first property of multiplication says that if we change the order of the digits, the answer will be same. Yes, now children, one by one, give me the example and write the example in the chat box. I will read the examples. Please write the example in the chat box. Rahil, what are you writing? Why no? Please write one example of this property, changing the order of the numbers, and write the example in the chat box. I will read it. Children, I'm not getting the answers. Prisha, please write the example in the chat box. Yes, Prisha has written 2 into 4 and 4 into 2 is 8. Very good. Please write the example of this commutative property. When you change the order of the numbers, you will get the same answer. Yes, Rudra, 5 into 3 and 3 into 5 is 15. Dhruv.
Ma'am, I have also written.
Dhruv, now this is the new property. You have to write the example of the property. Not repeated addition, I'm asking right now. Yes, Prisha has again written 9 into 2 and 2 into 9 is 18. Kahan, 8 into 2 and 2 into 8 is 16. Yes. Very good. Please write the example in the chat box. Vansh has written into 4 and 4 into 8 is 32. Arna, 5 into 2 and 2. Arna, please check. You have written 5 into 2 is 10 and 2 into 10 is 10. Please check your example, Anna. Mohit, I am reading everyone's. Mohit has written 2 into 4 and 4 into 2 is 8. Good. Prisha, 5 into 5 and 5 into 5. Okay. When the digits are same, then also when you change the order, the answer will be same. Kahan Jain, 9 into 2 and 2 into 9. Priya, 8 into 5 and 5 into 8 is 40. Parinika, yes, 14 into 8 and 8 into 14 is 112. 2 into 4 and 4 into 2 is 8. 7 into 2 and 2 into 7. Yes, Jishna is right. 6 into 12 and 2 into 6. It means that when you change the order of the numbers, you will get the same answer. This is the multiplication property number 1. Now, the property number 2 about the property of 0. What do you, who will explain the property of 0?
Yes, ma'am, see my also.
Ma'am, see my also.
Let me talk with Vivan first. Yes, Vivan. Vivan, tell me what is your problem.
Ma'am, see mine also.
Children, I'm reading. I'm trying to read all, but it is not possible to read. You have to write in the chat box. I will get the print of the chat box. I will read it later on. Okay? Yes, next property is property of 0. Who will explain me the multiplication property of 0? What do you understand by this?
Ma'am, can I?
Let Samriddhi first speak.
Ma'am, when a number multiplied by 0, it will come.
Samriddhi, wait, let me mute. Arya. Yes, Samriddhi, speak, please.
Yeah. When any number is multiplied by 0, the answer will be also 0. The example, 10 multiplied by 0 equals to 0.
Yes. So please, now next property you have to write in your notebooks. Multiplication property.
Ma'am.
Whenever 0 is one of the factors, the product is 0. For example, 3. Multiplicative.
Ma'am, can you do second?
Please write the second property in your notebooks. Multiplicative property of 0. When 0 is the factor, means when you are multiplying any number with the 0, you will get the answer 0. Whether it is 0 5s are, 5 zeros are, answer will be 0. Yes, please write the examples of multiplication property of 0 in the chat box. Yes, yes, Rudra. Kahan, please correct it and write it again. Yes, Arya. Yes, Rudra. 6 into 0 is 0. Vivan, please check. 10 into 0 and 0. Here we are not learning about the order property, only the 0 property. Yes, 20 into 0 is 0. 10 into 0 is 0. 3 to 0 is 0. Kahan has written. Prisha has written. Yes, Ayansh. Vivan. Please, I want everyone has to write one example. Yes, Jishna. Yes. So means when you multiply any number with the 0, you will get the answer as the 0. So this is the multiplication property of 0. Now next property, multiplication property of 1 by 1. So when you multiply any number,
1 and any other number is the number itself.
Means you will get the same answer.
Excuse me, ma'am, I have a doubt.
Yes, tell me.
ma'am, these all properties you are showing, that all only we have to write, no, in the notebook?
Yes, yes, you all have to write in the notebook. All properties you have to write in the notebook. If you're not able to complete in the classroom, I will send this video in your not able to complete right now, I will send it into the classroom. You will complete it in the notebooks. And on the basis of this, I will send you the one worksheet. Please complete it. It is based on the multiplication only, right? Today's worksheet also based on the multiplication. So complete that also. Again, I will show you. Please complete this. When you multiply any number with the one, you will get the same answer. For example, 1 multiplied by 6 equals to 6. Now, meantime, I will ask you questions also from you. In that multiplication, you will not use pen and paper. You will mentally do the multiplication. I will tell the child name. That child will answer me. Yes. Now, I will call the names from the chat box. Arna Agarwal. Arna, you are there in the class? Arna.
Yes, ma'am.
Arna, can you please tell me what is 101 multiplied by 1 gives you what?
Ma'am, the answer will be 101 only, because when we multiply any number with 1, we get the answer itself.
Very good. Next is Anvi Kothari. Anvi Kothari?
Yes, ma'am.
You have learned the zero property also, right? When you multiply 10 with the 100, what will be the answer?
Ma'am, 10 multiplied with 100. Ma'am,
what will be the answer?
Ma'am, it will be
8. You have learned in the last classes when we were doing multiplication, then when we multiply number with the number and add the zeros.
Yes.
So easy.
So now tell me, 10 multiplied by 100, what will be the answer?
Ma'am, 1000.
Very good. Yes, now are you Singhania? Are you Singhania? You have learned the zero property, right? If I say 999 yes. multiplied by 0, what will be the answer?
Ma'am, 999 multiplied by 0 is equal to 999 only.
Multiply by 0.
Zero. The answer is zero.
Yes. My next question is from Freya. Freya? Freya, you are there? Freya, please answer me.
Excuse me, Renu, ma'am.
Freya, tell me. Yes, Lama, wait. Freya, tell me, when you multiply 20 multiplied by 20, what will be your answer?
20 multiplied by 20 equals 400.
Yes. What will be the answer?
400.
Very good. Now my next question is from Kahan Jain. Kahan Jain. Yes, Lama, please go. Kahan Jain, you are there in the class?
Yes, ma'am.
108 multiplied by 10, what will be the answer? If you multiply any number with the 10, 100, 1000, how you will multiply?
Ma'am, what?
108 multiplied by 1000. Sorry, 108 multiplied by 10.
108 multiplied by 10.
Multiply number with the number and add the 0. 108 multiplied by 10.
Ma'am, 10.
What will be the answer?
Ma'am, 10 only.
No, how it is 10 only, my dear child?
Ma'am, can I say?
Yes, Ayansh, please tell.
1080.
Yes. Mm-hmm. 1080 means 108 multiplied by 1 is the 108. And then add the 0 at the last. Whenever you multiply any number with the 10, 100, 1000, you just multiply the number with the number and add the zero at the last. Yes? Now, my next question is from Dhairya Shah. Dhairya?
Yes, ma'am.
Dhairya, please tell me 100 multiplied by 40 will be what?
100 multiplied by 40.
100 multiplied by 40.
By 40. 40.
In 100, which is the number?
What, ma'am?
In 100, except 0, which number is there?
Ma'am, 4,000.
Yash, wait, my dear. Yash and Vivan, please wait. If I'm asking this from someone... Dhairya, listen my question carefully.
Okay.
In 100, how many zeros are there?
Two.
And what is the number along with the 100? Migdad, I know it.
Four.
No, in 100, what is the number? Except
10.
Two. One is there, 100.
Yeah.
And in 40, it is 40.
Yeah.
So how you will multiply 100 with the 40? How directly?
Ma'am, 4,000.
How 4, it is 4,000? Can you please explain me?
Yeah. Look, when it is 4 and 0, so 4 and 0 is there only, and the 0 which is with 10 will add it. Both the 0 of 100 will add with 40.
Okay. And see, if it is 200 multiplied by 40, then what will be the answer?
200 multiplied by 40. It
yes.
will be...
How it is 42?
8,000.
Yeah, yes.
8,000.
Yes. The number in the 200 is 2, and the number in the 40 is 4. Multiply the number with the number, which is 8, and add the.
Ma'am, I know one way also. Ma'am,
yes,
ma'am, you say no 400 multiplied by 100, 200, and if we all add the zeros and put one number, it will make 1,000. Yes,
so
ma'am.
What is your answer?
Ma'am?
800. Rudra, wait. Lakshya, you do one thing. You write your question in the chat box. Okay. Along with the digits, write in the chat box. I will check it.
Okay. What?
Okay. Let me show this with the other properties.
Ma'am, I want to ask.
Associative property.
Look at the example. 5 into 3 into 2. Let us group two numbers.
Right now, I will send this video. You first have to understand this.
And then find the answer. First, let us group 5 into 3. In brackets into 2, which is equal to 15 into 2, which is equal to 30. Now let us group 3 and 2 in the brackets into 5, which is equal.
Change the group also, then also the answer will be same.
Equal to 5 into 6. Which is equal to 30. In both the cases, we got the same answer, that is 30. Thus, we say when three or more numbers are multiplied, the product is the same, regardless of how the numbers are grouped. We can say that multiplication is associative.
So these are all the properties of multiplication. I will send this video. I will send this video. You will complete it in the classroom and listen.
Can see my this chart.
Lakshya, mute your mic.
I'm telling you.
Lakshya has written 4 plus. Lakshya, it is 4 plus 1000 or 4 multiplied by 1000.
Then my mobile has no is equal to, so I written line.
Okay, so your mobile is not having a multiply sign also?
Yeah. No, I have only this. In computer, it is also this. And mobile also.
Okay. So in place of, if you don't have a sign, you can use the word multiply or you can write the spelling, right? Okay. Otherwise, I will read it as a plus. Okay. So, now listen to me, everyone. What I am going to post in the classroom today? Today I am going to post this video in the classroom so that you will. Please mute your mics, everyone, and listen to me carefully. Today I am going to post this in the classroom, the video which we have done, and you all have to complete this in your notebooks. And on the basis of this, on the multiplication tables, I'm going to send you one worksheet. You have to complete it. Along with that, I am going to post it. What are we going to learn tomorrow? So that you will be ready that what are we going to learn tomorrow? And the activity which we are going to do tomorrow, you should be ready with the material which I will post. Please check your classroom today so that you will have the material. Okay? I'm going to post the material also, that what material you will be needed for tomorrow's activity class and the topic which we are going to cover tomorrow. Am I clear today?
Wait a minute. Bye, ma'am.
No, bye. I'm clear it first. Please let me clear what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Ma'am.
So today we have done about the multiplication. We have recalled the properties of multiplication and what is related to the topic in which is in our textbook, that we are going to cover it from tomorrow. So be ready with the material and be ready what are we going to learn tomorrow and complete this in your textbooks, sorry, in your notebooks today. Thank you for today's class.